Prime Minister Modi's cabinet third time has taken shape and Bihar seems to have emerged as the state with the maximum representation in the union cabinet. At least 8 ministers are coming from the state of Bihar. These are people from JDU, from BJP, from Chirag Paswan's LJP Ram Vilas, also from Jitin Ram Majhi's Hindustan Awam Morcha. In this balance, we are also seeing not just alliance partners getting a seat in the Union Council of Ministers, but also caste equations being balanced. So what are some of the caste representations that we are seeing? For the upper caste, there is a Brahmin minister there in the form of Satish Dubey. Satish Dubey is joining the Union Council. There are two other upper caste Bhumihar representatives in the Union Council, Lalan Singh from JDU and Giriraj Singh from the Bharatiya Janata Party. Initially, there was speculation that how will two competing Bhumihar faces make it to the Modi Council? Will one of them have to make way? But looks like both of them are getting a seat in the Union Council. Giriraj Singh is the Bhumihar face from Bihar BJP, while Lalan Singh, the choice of Nitish Kumar, is making it into the Union Cabinet as well. JDU, in fact, has one MOS and one minister in the cabinet rank. For MOS, Ramnath Thakur, son of Karpuri Thakur, is making it to the Union Council. He's getting MOS status is what we are being told. He's from the Nai or the Baba community. So that's an EBC quota, the extremely backward caste quota that the BJP is targeting or the NDA is targeting by ensuring that he finds a place in the Union Council. Jitin Ram Majhi himself from the Musahar community, extremely backward, Mahadalit so to say. So his representation in the Union Council is also of significance, not just for NDA, but also in terms of caste dynamics. For the others, if you see the Nishad community or the Malla community getting represented by Rajbhushan Nishad, Nityanand Rai, MOS home, he's an Ahir from the Yadav community. He's also finding a place in the Union Council. Will he get an MOS status again? You know, that was what the speculation was all about. But nevertheless, if you see overall, like I explained, there are Brahmins, there are Bhumihars, there are Yadavs, there are Dalits and Mahadalits. Chirag Paswan, the Dalit representation there, he's proved that he is the true heir of Ram Vilas Paswan's political legacy, having scored a strike rate of 5-on-5, 100% strike rate. And we also saw Prime Minister Modi's fondness for Chirag Paswan at the Central Hall of Parliament after Chirag came and spoke from the dais. He was given a warm embrace by the Prime Minister. So he could, you know, he could get a very meaty role in the new Modi government as well. What it's making things also interesting for Bihar is that if you compare it with Uttar Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh has 80 Lok Sabha seats, whereas if you see the number of ministers making it from UP, there are 6. Bihar, in fact, is at 8 currently and they have only 40 people or 40 Lok Sabha seats there. So it looks like Prime Minister Modi realizes the importance of Bihar. It's also looking at Lok Sabha, after Lok Sabha elections, the assembly polls that are coming up in Bihar. Tejaswi Yadav versus Muslim Yadav combination and trying to get in the other caste also to make a wider caste rainbow. He's snapping at the heels of the Nitish Kumar government, of the NDA government in Bihar. So is this Modi 3.0 council also a way to ensure that Bihar gets its due before the upcoming assembly elections? Council of Ministers, Cabinet Ministers aside, it will also be interesting to note what Bihar gets in terms of financial package. That's what Nitish Kumar wants. Enough money in the hands of the government there so that more development opportunities can be created, more money can be transferred directly into the bank accounts. 2 lakh rupees has been promised for below poverty line Biharis. Also, economic distress. Palayan is a big issue there. So what can be done to ensure employment? These are big ticket issues for Bihar. And the way the Modi Council is being formed is a definitive message that Prime Minister is looking at Bihar with a lot of concern, care and willing to give it a helping hand.